So that'll help us average the runners in score position. The breaking ball, Ichiro is set up to slap the ball left field, which is right into his power.
Yeah, right.
And he does have a little power. Split the outfielders to the 420 mark. And he can still run a bit.
How about the choice of 3-1 breaking ball to Ichiro with the base open and sitting on it?
And that's an example of a freelance. That's not your normal pitch. It's sort of a trick of mentality here. You can't possibly be looking for this right now. But it did play right into his power. He's set up to hit the ball to left field. And then he throw a breaking ball that kind of speeds up his bat in. Gets it out front where he can put a charge into it.
Here's Jeter, infield in. Jeter lined out to short his first time. He bats now with a runner at third. Two runs in. And the Yankees on top, 2-0.
It sounded like they were booming the call. The called strike. There should be a special rule for Derek today. There's no balls that are called strikes. Those two pitches are really almost the same pitch.
I know pitching against Pete Rose in his last year, he could not get a called strike. We were just hoping Pete put it into play.
Sixth on the all-time hit list. Number one on the active list. 1-2.
Derek does a good job of hitting the fastball the other way and protecting with two strikes. So again, it's the same mindset as Ichiro a little bit. You can't really fool him with a breaking ball in the strike zone. He will chase a breaking ball out, or he's susceptible to a high fastball. But an off-speed pitch in the strike zone is not a good pitch to throw to Derek with two strikes.
Here comes the 1-2. High chopper. Happy fielded in third. That's going to go as an infield hit for Jeter on the Baltimore chop. And for the second straight day, Jeter with a hit of the infield variety. And it's 3-0 Yankees.
Took that ball out of play. Could be his last day.
It could be. In a day and age where hitters free swing with two strikes, that was really important for him to make contact.
This is going to be it. Pinch runners coming on. Listen to the hand for Derek Jeter. Of Derek Jeter here at Fenway Park.
Sunglasses, a big help for Mr. Jeter this afternoon.
Charles and Dorothy watching along with the rest here at Fenway, the end of a 20-year career. It has been marked by nothing but class, integrity, incredible hard work and winning. Sports Illustrated coming out this week with the exit interview by Tom Verducci. And this quote from Jeter caught my eye. One of the biggest things about leadership is you have to get to know your teammates. You have to get to know who you're leading because there's different buttons you push with different people. Some guys you can yell and scream at. Some guys you have to put your arm around. You can do that only if you get to know them as people. You saw him walk off the field here at Fenway. And that guy is beloved not by fans alone, but by teammates. And they don't come around often, Jeff.
No, I mean, I was just trying to internalize that myself. He handles himself a certain way. He's got a great sense of awareness and an instinct for people that allows him to help them. And I'm sure that goes way beyond what happens in between the white lines. He just has that natural ability to help and to lead.
I think it's so interesting because you know this as well as I do, Cal. It takes a village of people to help you get to this position, this place. And certainly number one for Derek is his family. And I find it ironic that he leaves the field with a big smile and his parents with tears because of all they put into it.
Yeah, they're happy tears.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Two balls, two strikes, Brett Gardner waiting. Brian McCann, by the way, is a pinch runner at first. He'll take over as the DH. Here was the moment. As Joe Girardi said, he would leave it up to Derek Jeter. After reaching on the infield hit, all right, Brian McCann, get ready to run.
He's probably saying, who's running for me, McCann? No, maybe I'll stay in. Who would ever throw McCann out as a bench runner? And of course, the DH now.
This may be the first time Brian McCann's ever been called on the pitch run. In the air to left. Rince is back and having all kinds of issues with that. Off the green monster. McCann will hold up at third. And one of those moments for the youngster, Bryce Rince in left, got all turned around and got all dirty on the warning track.
This is one of those balls that gets you turned around, but then the sun is a factor in that trying to find the ball. It's not a green monster moment here. It's not the defense is closed.
Golfers, when they miss a putt, tap in a spot.